patient. You say I'm not in love, you say that I'm daydreaming, baby. Well, if I'm daydreaming, then call me your phone. Please don't be friends. Hey guys, welcome to another vlog. It is Monday, May 2nd today, and it's a disgusting day outside. I went for a run. For those of you guys that don't know, I run 5 days a week, 4 days sometimes, four to five days a week. Try to do anywhere from 30 to 35K a week, which is about 6 to 8 a day, depending on how I'm feeling and what I got going on and all that stuff. But today was one of those days that, actually on Friday I was running and I hurt my foot like really bad. I don't know what's wrong with it. I've had pain in my right foot before, but this is a completely different type of pain. So as you can tell, I'm driving. I only did like 1K, like 4 laps, not even, like 3.5 laps, which for me sucks because for my mental stability, I need to run a little bit more. And I feel like I am constantly being pulled back, and it really, really, really sucks. So that is where I'm at right now. So I just got home. I'm gonna shower and do my shit. Do everything that I really need to do. I'm thinking of actually today going through and cleaning out my closet, because I do need to kind of somewhat stay active, because I didn't really get to run. So yeah, it's kind of sad. Makes me sad. But I am gonna I don't know what I'm saying anymore. I think I should just park my car and then I will talk to you guys in a bit. It has been kind of a really, really crazy morning for me, because even though I didn't get to fully run, I had to make an appointment for my podiatrist, because I really want to know what the problem is. I hope it's not, I don't want it to be fractured or broken anywhere in there, and then I don't want to make it worse by constantly being on my feet, because I am the type of person that's like, literally it's so difficult for me to actually sit in one spot. I know it's like you crazy girl, like why is that so difficult for you to just sit? It's like I want to sit on the days that I have like no problem with me, but the days that I'm in like I should be sitting, I don't. So yeah, those are my problems. So I have been making and I had to make, okay, hold on, this is like, let's put this down. Okay, that's a weird angle, but I need my hands. So I had to make an appointment with my podiatrist, which I had made originally for May 9th because he wasn't available. And then he called me back and was like, okay, he has an opening today. So I made that appointment for 3 p.m. And at the same time then, like there was some paperwork from my orthotics that like I submitted, but they didn't issue me any of the money. So there was some more paperwork that they actually needed, and I was on hold with them, waiting for someone to come on the call for about 45 minutes, and then the girl's computer kept freezing. So she's like, you know what, just give me your number and I will give you a call back. So she did that, and she was like, this is what you need to submit all that. And so I did, Okay, so she told me what I needed, and the fact that, like, I like to keep everything very organized, whereas my husband likes is just an absolute disaster when it comes to paperwork and like paperwork, like medical paperwork or like anything for my son's school or home paperwork, government paperwork, anything like that. I have everything kind of divided. So like different folders for different paperwork, but he doesn't do it that way. He just kind of throws it in. So now when I was looking for the paperwork that I was that was supposed to be submitted, which he said, my husband said he did, I couldn't find it because it wasn't in the right folder that it's supposed to be. So I spent like I don't know how long, and yet I still couldn't find that paperwork. And now I'm just kind of all over the place. So I am gonna leave that to him now, because if he can't organize himself, then I can't do the work. Like I can't, if he's asking me to pull out that paperwork while he's at work, I can't do that because it's not freaking organized, and it drives me up the wall because then I have to sit there, and the fact that it's not organized, I'm gonna start organizing it. And that is something that is gonna be added into my day that wasn't even supposed to be there, and I won't get the stuff done that I need to get done. That was a rant. Huge rant. So yeah. Okay. Give me 1 second. So I literally like just washed this the other day and I put it on. I was like, yeah, nice and clean. I'm gonna wear it. And as soon as I put it on, guess what happens? I get another freaking makeup stain on it. And that is freaking annoying. So I'm gonna use this guy. I got it from Winners. It's a spot remover, so hopefully I don't have to put the whole thing in the wash again, because I don't want to constantly be like washing it. And the thing is that I have to wash it with other whites, and that means that I have to wait for other whites to get dirty, and the other ones aren't dirty. So now I am just gonna like kind of rub this in, and hopefully that will take it away. Because honestly, sometimes even the wash won't really take away. And I should be doing this in my bathroom because it's like dripping on my dresser. And I think that kind of cleaned it off, except for the fact that. Okay, so now I'm just gonna actually rinse it in the water so it doesn't leave like kind of like. Okay, I'll be right back. I think that did the job. Like it's gone. So this thing for makeup is really good, I think. I'm just gonna kind of hang this on the door so it can dry. Okay, so my plans today was to kind of organize my closet because it's an absolute disaster. Let me show you guys what this guy looks like. My finger. I don't even know how to like. That's how that looks like. And I'm gonna start. I think I'm just gonna pull everything out, and the things that I don't wear anymore, I don't know what I'm gonna do with them, because I honestly don't. All my stuff is fairly new, I would say. And I'm the type of person that, like, I don't like to throw away too much stuff. Okay, so hopefully this works. Okay, you know what? Let's see. I should just bring my freaking stand here. Funny how I just basically just ranted about me being super organized, but yet I'm living in this disaster right here. To me, it's a very organized disaster. Like I kind of know where everything is, But now it's like I keep wearing the same things over and over again because I just keep pulling it out from the top. So we are gonna start from all the denim, and I am literally just gonna like throw it down. And the denim is the easy part. Like this stuff is pretty easy for me to organize, I would say. 'Cause believe it or not, I don't have very much denim. According to me. And I think a lot of you would have to agree, and these are hoodies, that like if you look at my denim, it's not very much according to like the what some people have. I do have a lot more like kind of up there in my closet, which maybe I should like kind of pull down as well, but like where am I gonna put it? The thing is, yeah, I don't know what to think. I am just gonna actually start and we'll see how this goes. Take these off. Oh my God. My glasses hide my bags. Like, do you see? That's so bad. Okay. You know when you start something and then you're in the middle of it and you're just like, shit, man. Why did I even start this? Why? Like, kill me already. Why did I do this? Okay, so I think I'm gonna stop this vlog here, whereas this is all empty, and just kinda, I'm kinda falling asleep, so I feel like I need some music. And if I turn on music, YouTube is not gonna let me. Yeah. There's copyright issues. Okay, it's the next day and I look like a mess. Update. I had to go get an x-ray for my foot because my podiatrist said that it could be a stress fracture. Now I'm waiting for the results today. He said that if he doesn't call, that means all is good. I just need to kind of hold off on any sort of impact exercise, like my run, so kind of slow down a little bit. I know personally, like I realize that I kind of go overboard. Every single time I try to do 8K, I somehow manage to injure myself. Why that hasn't like sunk in, I have no idea. This is like the second time, so I need to make sure that I am not doing that anymore. I need to bring it down a lot, so at least I can somewhat get some sort of exercise in. Yeah, so that's where I'm at, and honestly, I am really sad about it because right now I'm supposed to be running and I'm not, and I don't know what to do with myself right now. So it's like I have a routine and now I need to figure out something completely different. And I feel like every single time I am doing really well with my health and exercise and everything, something always seems to bring it down. And it really sucks, you know, especially when you enjoy it. But yeah, that's where I'm at. So I think I am gonna do a little, I'm gonna take a shower, wash this hair of mine, and maybe do a little get ready with me. Yeah, before I have breakfast. So yeah, as far as yesterday and what I was doing for cleaning out the closet, I've kind of put my clothes away, but now like my sweaters and everything are on the ground. It is a slow process because I don't know where to put all this stuff. So I can show you what it looks like.
It looks like that. Like I've used one whole shell for my jeans, so it stays a little bit more neater. And then I've put my hoodies here. I want to somehow hang up my hoodies, but I don't think I have enough space for that. The only thing see, I've put all my like my dresses and my skirts and everything down there. And I think I'll put some of my like dress pants and leather pants here. And then that is my sweaters on this side. And then if I go this way, I've got some more sweaters here on the floor. And then I did end up putting all my like other loose t-shirts in the drawer here. And I have like, see, I have some of the in like my shirts and my pants, but I need those shirts in a drawer that's a little bit higher. And then, so I'm thinking that maybe I need to take my these shirts of mine out. Yeah, I don't know. I honestly don't know how I could possibly fit hoodies in here too, because like my whole thing is packed with jackets and sweaters, like cardigans and stuff. But and then I have like this section of shirts. I just don't know how I would fold them and put them in here where they just don't become a mess. Like I would have to put them here and then put these over there. And I think that this is gonna take more space in there. So I don't know how I'm gonna do that, how I'm gonna tackle that. But for now, I am just gonna take my shower. I still want to eat the same at the same time as I normally do because I don't want to shock my body too much. And then maybe tomorrow I can hopefully just go and walk and like depending on if I get a call from the doctor. So if he calls, that is not good news. If he doesn't call, that is good news. If he calls, that means they're gonna have to put a boot on my foot. And I don't want that for 8 weeks, especially with the weather getting warmer. And living here, you kind of wait for the weather to get warmer because we only get a few months of warm weather. And the last thing I want to be doing is having a freaking boot on my foot. Okay, let's go. Okay, I know that this angle is kind of weird and whatever, but like I have my phone kind of placed up on a basket. So yeah, I don't have one of those small little like Joby things to hold my phone or camera on. Mine is really big when I'm filming videos. But I am just gonna quickly show you how I dry my hair after I shower. I will take my comb. This is Drunk Elephant. I got it in a set with like the conditioner and like scalp thingamajiggy and shampoo. I don't like the smell of their shampoo very much. I do use their conditioner because it really makes my hair super, super nice. And I don't use the scalp thing. I just don't have the patience for that. So it is wet, and I do kind of like go through it. They say it's okay to use a comb like this when your hair is wet and combing through it because it doesn't really pull at your hair. And I'm telling you, when you're using that Drunk Elephant conditioner, it just kind of like glides through. And my hair is like kind of shedding. So I do that. And then I take a little bit of my mousse. This is just the OGX Coconut Curls Creamy Mousse. And I like put very little of it, mostly just to give it a little bit of grip and fullness, I would say. So literally like this much.
of it. And just kind of, and I keep majority of it. That was a little too much. And I keep majority of it at the bottom, not too much on the roots, because my hair gets greasy really fast. Literally, I have to wash my hair on the second day. So I've washed it on Sunday, and now it's Tuesday, and I had to wash it today. And whatever is left over, then I would go to the top part of it. And I do get a lot of hair that kind of comes out. It's getting better, but yeah, I know that this angle is like really, really terrible, but I mean, I can't really do anything. Okay, so yeah, so do that. And then sometimes I do go in with this guy. This is a blow drying serum. It's called Jumpstart. And it's supposed to kind of smoothen your hair. It's not really needed, but I kind of like the smell of this stuff. It's from Dry Bar. So it's just like a mini little thing. Take my brush, the wide one, the really big one, and my T3 dryer. And that is about, I go super high on high heat because I don't have the patience. When I'm using a dryer, I don't fully dry my hair completely. That would take me forever. So at this point, I would dry it as much as I could and then let it air dry a little bit after I will go in with my straightener. I don't have any techniques either. I just want to make sure that there's all the frizzes kind of gone and it's smooth and there's no flyaways, because I usually end up either using a straightener or a curling iron to actually curl it. So my dryer is just there to dry them.
That perfume, you know, the one that you bought me. Every time you come around, I know that you will love it. Come and make some good times, forget about the bad times. Baby, can't make up my mind and I know you get impatient. You say I'm not in love, you say that I'm daydreaming, baby. Well, if I'm daydreaming, then come get some sleep with me. Don't worry about it, please don't be frantic. You are my love. You are my.
You a real nigga, main one. You was there before I came up. It's evident how you feel about the fella, you ain't gotta say nothing. You keep it A1, solidify like a day one. Lightweight in love with you just to be straight up. Tucked off in the loft, bullin', we be laid up. Late nights at the studio, you be waiting up, trying to stay up. Hey, fuck all that makeup. Little booty, but she caked
okay,
up.
So I'ma wake up and eat quake some. I'll tell you where the time has gone. It has gone wasting time on freaking trying to shop online, trying to find items. So how many of you guys, like, I get so pissed off at the H&M website. It's like every single item that you get, like, love or it's trending or whatever, the sizes are literally gone right away. And so today they're giving like 25% off one item. And I have been on a hunt for platform mules, and H&M had these, but they don't have my size. And they've been gone for so long. And then today I went on to look if they're back. They were back, but there's no sizes. It just says notify me. That is freaking annoying. Anyways, I am going to go ahead and straighten my hair. I just plugged it in. I have the T3 Thin Straightener. Had this for a really long time. If you guys are looking for it, I know Costco has it.
Okay guys, I don't know if I can actually be, like if this is gonna look good to you guys while I'm driving, because I'm in a completely different car and have my phone set up in a weird angle. It's kind of trippy, but I'm just gonna go for a roots touch up and a haircut, which I am super excited about because I am gonna cut it short again. So I literally haven't gotten a haircut since, I would say, last year. April was the last time I got a haircut. I don't get haircuts on a regular. I just don't feel like I need to, because it just always the same length. Like, it's not layered or anything, it's just one length except the front, and I was kind of growing out my bangs anyway, so yeah. But I have this urge, like, I've already done the whole curtain bag thing, so I'm kind of almost over it pretty much. Sometimes I'm like, maybe I want to keep it, but let me tell you, curtain bangs are a lot of work, a lot of maintenance, and I just don't have the patience for it, because every time it flips the other way, it starts to annoy me. So, and my hair is very flat, and like when I straighten it, which is what I usually do because it's quicker for me, it doesn't work sometimes, because I mean it works, but it's just like a lot of maintenance to keep that kind of bounce going and stuff. And if I don't wash it every day, it just kind of like flattens again, and I don't got the time for that. So yeah, so I'm thinking I am just gonna go completely short. And I have gone short last year, which was my hair, the haircut that I had prior to this, and it was like up to here. But I'm thinking of going any even shorter. But my biggest thing is I need to be able to pull my hair back into some sort of a, not a ponytail, but just to be able to tie it up. That's my biggest thing, because I just like to sometimes have my hair out of my face, and I don't like to put hair bands on and clips on, because the clips leave like little dents, if you know what I mean. Yeah, so that's where I'm at, and we'll see. My appointment was at 3:30. I did call them ahead of time and ask them if I can come in earlier, and they said yes. I'm not gonna be that much earlier, probably about 15 minutes earlier, but still better than nothing. Yeah, other than that, I have absolutely nothing to say. It's in a different city. My haircut place is in a different city. It's not that far of a city, but getting out of the city that I live in, it takes a long time. It's just I live right in the central part of my city, so like the downtown area, and there's just a lot of traffic in this area. And yeah, it just takes a while just to get out of the city that I live in. All right, okay, so I am gonna let you go, and I am actually gonna listen to some music, and I would put it on, but freaking YouTube and copyright, so that ain't gonna work. Okay, I will talk to you guys in a bit. That's my haircut. This is the color. It looks amazing. It was a long process because I had to get the hair colored as well. So I don't have the patience to actually sit down and do this stuff, but yeah. Oh my gosh. All right, let's get going. Thank you.
wear that perfume, you know the one that you bought me. Every time you come around, I know that you will love it. Come and make some good times, forget about the bad times. Baby, can't make up my mind.
And we are in the United States because we had to get some gas and it's super expensive where I live. Yeah, so we just came out here, just enjoying this actually beautiful weather. It's Monday morning, so look at those views. It's just absolutely beautiful. Okay, guys. I just got back a little while ago. We were in the States. If you don't already know, I live in Canada and very close to the border. So yeah, Vancouver. And we were just in the States to fill up our car. Gas prices in Canada are super duper expensive right now. Almost $2.20 per liter. So we do go towards like Point Roberts, which is not too far away, about I would say about half an hour or so, and fill it up there, and it makes a huge difference. So that's what we were doing, and it's an absolutely beautiful place. Like, just it's like a little part of the States that's not really attached to the States. It's attached to Canada. So it's attached to Canada, but it's United States, and it's not attached to the United States at all. In order for any American to get there, they have to come through Canada, so cross that Canadian border and then come that way around. Yeah. Anyways, that's what was up today. And then now, because of my foot, I'm still not able to run. It kind of hurts even when I walk. So I need some sort of fitness in. So I am going to try to do some low impact cardio just off of YouTube now. And we'll see how that goes. And other than that, nothing else is really planned. And then maybe take a shower. And that is about it. I woke up really tired today. Okay, so now I am gonna go and try and get a little bit of a workout.
You a real nigga, main one. You was there before I came up. 7 in, how you feel about the fella? You ain't gotta say nothing. You keep it A1, solidified like a day one. Lightweight in love with.